NETStudy 2.0, Resuming and Submitting Studies, Minnesota Department of Human Services, Office of Inspector General, Background Studies Division. Welcome to the training video on resuming and submitting a background study application in NETStudy 2.0. This training video contains some of the main functionality of the NETStudy 2.0 system. Due to ongoing refinements to the system, you may see slight variations between the screens shown in this video and the version of NETStudy 2.0 you will use. For this video, and in the NETStudy 2.0 system, the term provider refers to the NETStudy 2.0 user at the program, facility, educational program, or other entity that initiates background study applications. You can resume an application that has been successfully initiated from the not yet submitted queue. If a background study fee was applied as part of this application, that application would be included in this queue as well. To go to the not yet submitted queue, hover your mouse over the Applications tab. In the drop-down, click Not Yet Submitted. The Not Yet Submitted queue contains applications that have been initiated but not yet completed or submitted. Near the top of the page, you will find filtering options, including application number, provider, and last name. These filtering options allow you to easily search through the applications in this queue. If you decide not to move forward with submitting a background study request for the study subject, or the study subject self-selects out of the process, the application must be withdrawn. To withdraw an application, click the Withdraw button under the Actions column on the right side of the screen. When the Confirm Withdraw box appears, select the appropriate withdraw reason from the drop-down, then click the Withdraw button in the lower right side of the box. Notice that the application is now removed from the queue. To resume an application, click the Resume button in the Actions column on the right side of the screen, and you will be routed to the Profile page. Fill in the study subject's personal information. The required fields are identified by a red asterisk and include first, middle, and last name, date of birth, address, race, sex, eye color, height, weight, and place of birth. The personal descriptive information is required by the Minnesota Bureau of Criminal Apprehension and the Federal Bureau of Investigation to conduct fingerprint-based criminal record checks. A selection must be entered in the race field, but if the study subject chooses not to provide this information, you may select unknown from the drop-down. Notice that the first name, last name, date of birth, and, if provided, the social security number are pre-populated on the profile page with the information that was entered at the time the study was initiated. It is important for DHS to have the mailing address of the background study subject. If the mailing address is different from the person's permanent address, uncheck the Same as Permanent Address box under the Mailing Address section. A second address field will appear. In this field, enter the address where the individual receives mail. State law requires background study requests to include the study subject's prior names and aliases, such as a maiden name, married name, or nickname. If the study subject reports that they do not have a prior name or alias, click the checkbox stating that the individual reports that they have not been known by any other names. Otherwise, click the Add Alias button at the bottom of the screen in the Prior Names and Aliases box. When the Add Alias box displays, enter the prior name or alias, and then click the Save button in the lower right side of the box. State law also requires background study requests to include prior out-of-state addresses where the study subject resided in the last 5 years. If the subject reports that they have not resided outside Minnesota in the last 5 years, click the checkbox stating that the individual reports that they have not lived out of state during the specified time frame. To add prior addresses, click the Add Prior Address button at the bottom right of the screen within the Prior Out-of-State Addresses Within the Last 5 Years box. When the Add Prior Address box displays, complete the required fields indicated by the red asterisk, which includes the state, the year to, and the year from. Then click the Save button in the lower right side of the box. After you complete the profile page, click the Next button in the lower right side of the screen. The next screen is the Verify Identity page. On this page, you will record the identification document that the study subject provided to verify his or her identity for the background study. All fields on this screen are required. Verification of the study subject's identification occurs before the background study is initiated, but the documentation is recorded on this screen. In the document drop-down, select the appropriate document type, enter in the issuing state or authority, the document number, and expiration date. Then click the Next button in the lower right side of the screen. This will bring you to the Affiliation Information page, where you will record the study subject's expected position at your provider. All fields on this screen are required. The provider field auto-populates with the provider information that was selected when the application was initiated. It cannot be changed on this page. The fields that must be completed on this screen are position category, position, and employee type. You can refer to the NETStudy 2.0 user manual for a complete list of position categories and positions for easy reference. There will be a drop-down menu in the sections position category, position, and employee type. For each, select the category that best applies. To access the manual, hover your mouse over the Applications tab in the toolbar and click Application Forms, then click the NETStudy 2.0 User Manual link to open it in a new tab. Once you have completed this page, click the next button in the lower right side of the page. The next screen is the Research Registries page. This training video will have a brief overview of this page. For an in-depth training video, see our two-part video on registry checks in NETStudy 2.0. A link is in the description below. The registries included in this page are the Federal Office of Inspector General, List of Excluded Individuals and Entities, the Minnesota Exclusion List, and the Minnesota Nurse Aid Registry. The NETStudy 2.0 system will perform an auto-search against these databases to determine if there are any possible matches to study subjects in these databases. In addition, if the study subject has lived in any state other than Minnesota within the past 5 years, and this information was recorded on the profile page, your system will provide links for any publicly available professional registries for those states. The registry checks are not required to be completed as part of the background study, but some providers may be required to check them. The searches are manual. To complete these searches, click on the blue hyperlink in the registry name column, and the registry will open in a new tab. Then follow the instructions on the page to perform the search. The system will identify possible matches to study subjects on the Federal Exclusion List, the Minnesota Exclusion List, and the Minnesota Nurse Aid Registry in the Research Requirements column. Click the blue Match link to display the Match Results box. Then review the information and determine whether the potential match is the study subject. If the information matches the study subject, click the Confirm box in the Confirm column. If the information does not match the study subject, click the Ignore box in the Confirm column. Then click the Close button in the lower right side of the box. If the registry information belongs to the study subject and as a result you elect to discontinue the background study and affiliation process, select Match from the Research Results dropdown for that registry. The system will require you to add a comment. Comments are used to note the reason for discontinuing the application and not for communicating registry information to DHS. To add a note, click on the Add button in the Comments column for that registry. In the Add Note box, enter in the relevant information concerning the positive match, then click Save in the bottom right corner of the box. If the registry information belongs to the study subject and you elect to continue the background study application and affiliation, select Information Not Disqualifying from the Research Results dropdown of that registry. In this case, a note is not required. If there is a match on the federal and state exclusion lists and you receive federal or state funding, there may be significant consequences to selecting that the information is not disqualifying, including but not limited to payment recoveries, fines, and civil monetary penalties. If the identified match does not belong to the study subject, or if no possible matches were found, select No Match from the Research Results dropdown for that registry. No note is required. Once you have recorded the research results for each registry, click the Next button in the lower right side of the screen. The final page is the Data Review page. This page provides you with the opportunity to review the application information prior to submitting the application for processing. It is very important that the study subject's identifying information exactly matches the information on his or her ID. To review the information, click through the Profile tab, the Identity Verification tab, the Pre-Affiliation tab, and the Registry Results tab. It is very important that the information on this page is reviewed for accuracy and corrected if necessary before submission. Information that is submitted incorrectly will affect the person's ability to be fingerprinted and may also invalidate the background study. Click the Edit Applicant Profile button on the lower right side of the screen on the Profile tab to edit incorrect data. When you are ready to submit the application to DHS, click the Submit button on the lower right side of the screen. This will route you to the confirmation of submission page. The fingerprint and photo authorization form can be printed from the confirmation screen. For information on how to generate the authorization form, refer to the training video on that topic. A link is in the description below. This concludes the training video on resuming and submitting a background study. Thank you for your interest in this portion of NETStudy 2.0. Additional information is available in the NETStudy 2.0 user manual. To access the manual, hover over the Applications tab in the toolbar and click Application Forms. Then click the NETStudy 2.0 user manual link to open it in a new tab.